the only way to really find that peace is by shifting inside. But we're going to the wrong places. We're looking in the wrong places. We're doing the wrong things. If your finger were bleeding, you wouldn't go to a jewelry store looking for a band-aid or for somebody to fix it. You might find a nice ring or a nice necklace, but your finger would still be bleeding. Our hearts are bleeding. Our souls are bleeding. Our lives are bleeding. But we're going to the jewelry store, or we're going to the shopping mall, or we're going here, going there, thinking that somewhere in these places we're going to find a bandage for our finger. And it's not there. One of my favorite stories is a story of a woman who's searching in the road in the middle of the night, an old woman, and she's looking on the road underneath this very bright street light. And a wise man walks by and he says, "Mother, what are you looking for?" She says, "I've lost my key. Can you help me find it?" So he also gets down on his hands and knees and they search together. And after some time of not finding it, he says, "Mother, where did you lose your key?" She says, "Inside the house." And he says, "Well, then why in the world are you looking for it in the street?" And she says, "Because it's dark in the house. And here there's this wonderful bright street light, so I can see very, very clearly." He says, "Mother, go back inside. It might be dark, but eventually you'll find it." And we're doing the same things. It's not that there's anything wrong with being on the street in the night. Maybe she was out there watching the moonlight or taking a walk. That would be beautiful. It's not that being on the road in the night is wrong, or that owning wonderful things is wrong, or going shopping is wrong, or going to the jewelers is wrong, or going for vacation is wrong. It's what we're looking for in it that's the problem. If she were out there meditating on the moonlight, wonderful. If she were taking a walk, wonderful. If we're going to the shopping centers to find something we need, no problem. It's when we're going there looking for something that's not there that's the problem. The only place to turn, as in the story, is inward. The problem is that we've brought the chaos inward. So when we turn inward, when we sit for meditation, when we close our eyes, when we lie down in bed to go to sleep at night, there's the chaos. We've brought it all inward. So if we say the key is turn inward, then what do? We've brought so much of this chaos into our minds, into our hearts, into our lives. It's all about, what did this person say? What did that person say? What was she wearing? How did he look at her? How didn't she look at me? We play and replay over and over in our minds scenes and conversations that took place an hour ago, a week ago, 10 years ago. We play and replay in our minds over and over, rehearsing scenes and conversations that may or may not ever take place in the future. It's all about the desires, the fears, the judgments, the jealousies, the anger. It's no wonder that we can't have peace. But peace isn't something we have to go searching for. We just have to unearth it. We just have to remove all of this nonsense that we've brought into our lives on top of it. It's like if you're watching a normal TV that has one show going on at once, assuming you're watching something nice, it might be very restful, very relaxing to watch the show. But if you're watching one of these new TVs that have something in every single corner going on and news feeds running across the bottom and six or seven things going on simultaneously, even if you think you're enjoying it, they've done studies of the brain scans of people trying to make sense of what's going on the TV screen. The amount of chaos going on in the brain as we try to assimilate all of this information. If it was one thing, it was restful and relaxing. Once it becomes something in every corner, something across the top, something across the bottom, something downside, the overstimulation has brought this chaos. Children these days are being diagnosed all over the world in huge numbers with attention deficit disorder. Why? We filled their minds with chaos. We put them in front of machines that throw 10, 12, 15 things at them simultaneously. Every second, something else. It's no wonder they can't concentrate. It's no wonder they're not in peace. And it's the same thing in our lives. We sit for one thing, and 30 things are going on in our mind. I can't believe she said that. I can't believe he did that. I can't believe he didn't do that. Or we're 30 years ago. If only my parents this, or if only that. Or we're tomorrow. What if this happens? What if this doesn't happen? Or we're somewhere else. If only I could be there. If only I could own that. The key is spirituality. Spirituality focuses. It puts us on the path. It serves as this filter that just filters away unconsciously all of the rest.
To watch more, log on to www.erosentertainment.com.